explain what has happened this morning with SpaceX's Starship.
Right. Well, I think you just said it there earlier, Ed. They got even farther than they ever have before. It's very clear that SpaceX is making progress when it comes to the development of Starship. This flight lasted about an hour, which was kind of the planned flight time. Earlier flights lasted just a few minutes before the vehicle exploded. No explosions this time, and they achieved a number of amazing feats that they haven't before. They were able to reach near orbit, reach space, nearly lapped the Earth. Unfortunately, the vehicle did seem to burn up or be lost during re-entry into Earth's atmosphere, but they got
right.
even farther than they'd ever planned or ever expected before.
So let's show images of the re-entry. And there's an important technology point here, which is that SpaceX was able to maintain the camera images that you're seeing now because it had Starlink on board. And as it went from an altitude of, say, 100 kilometers downwards, it was bouncing the signal off so many Starlink satellites in orbit, Loren, to maintain that kind of high-fidelity connection. This is what I want to put the question to you, though, to quote one of the preeminent space minds, Buzz Lightyear. Is that flying, or is it just falling with style?
Well, the way that they set up this flight is it was always going to come down no matter what. It never was intended to reach a full orbit. It was always going to be suborbital. So gravity was always going to bring it down at some point. What they were hoping to see is if they could bring it back to Earth intact. And so they were kind of hoping that it would stay in one piece and splash down in the Indian Ocean. It looks like that did not happen. They've lost signal at this all from all of their different inputs at the same time, which indicates it probably burned up, probably was destroyed in some way. So yes, it was falling with style, but that was always the plan. But it did fly before that happened.
Ed Ludlow and his six espresso shots to the rescue, as he might have said too. I'm interested, Loren. Ultimately, like, we are potentially going to Mars. We are already with a NASA contract to go to the moon. Where does this put SpaceX?
Right. So with each of these flights, they learn a little bit more than last time. So I would say they're incrementally farther along than they were before. I mean, reaching near orbit was a huge achievement. They're going to need to be able to do that if they want to launch satellites from the vehicle. But there's still quite a long laundry list of things that they need to achieve in order for this vehicle to be a deep space vehicle. For instance, they need to demonstrate transferring super cold propellants between the tanks and the vehicle. They did have that demonstration on this flight. They were trying to see if they could transfer those propellants while in space. We aren't sure how that went, but they seem to have conducted the experiment. So we'll be eager to learn about how that went. And then they also have to come up with life support systems, demonstrate that it can land on other worlds like the moon. You know, there's a long way to go, but this does give some confidence that they are moving in the right direction.